just give you the basics of this. Get your act together. That's an old show business saying. We've all heard it, correct? We may even have used it at some time. Get your act together, which means you haven't got it together yet. When you've got your act together, you have a product to sell. And that's what you sell on stage, your product. That's what you sell in recordings. You've got to get your act together. And a lot of people walk around in circles with this confused mind about how do I get my act together. There are several ways you can do that. If you want to find out how successful people have done it, copy their formula. Write this down. Success leaves clues.
Everybody say, I just called to say I love you. I just called to say how much I care. Yeah, I just called to say I love you. And I mean it from the bottom of my heart.
Church Town Hall Television New Zealand presents That's Country. And your hosts, Wade Columbus, with Jane Hurley, Pat Kearns, Marie Humphreys, Patsy Ringer, Jeff Ray, Noel Parlay, Carter Edwards, Meryl Avon, Jenny Calder, Malcolm Heyman, Richie Biggott, and special guest, Narvel Phelps.
You're with somebody new. So leave the lights on when you love the boy. Keep your eyes wide open too. Your one and only loving baby is here for you.
Hello again. Our next guest cut his teeth on country, and it's still number one with him today. From Australia, Carter Edwards.
Some days a diamond, some days a stone. Sometimes a hard time won't leave me alone. Sometimes a cold wind blows a chill in my bones. 'Cause some days are diamonds and some days are stones.
I'd just like to say that take this opportunity to thank Carter. He's just been fantastic for young talent, and he actually gave me my first job to sing with a live band. So that was a pretty good start for me, and I don't think I'd be here today if it wasn't for him.
And how's your touch doing in your life? Like you're doing pretty well at the moment, and I've heard a lot of raps down in Sydney about you and that, so tell me, where's your career heading at this point in time?
Well, at the moment I'm going to be doing some writing, and I've been seeing on TV, and the experience that I've gained over the last 8 years or so, Carter started me off. I wouldn't be here today, as I said.
Really, Sticky?
I'm not taking all the blame. You had to have a bit of talent to start off with. It was pretty easy from then on, I'll tell you.
But I never met a man like Carter. Agree?
Yeah!
Exactly. Just amazing, Carter, ladies and gentlemen. Good luck with your career, man. All right, Tuna, would you like to just tell us a little bit about Carter and how he's sort of he's been an inspiration to your life?
Yeah, definitely. Well, as Nathan said earlier, Carter gave Nathan his first gig, and I got my first paid job through Carter. He made me a very rich 10-year-old at the time. but seriously, he always had really good things and so much encouragement to give me, which really, you know, boosted my confidence, and I learned so much from watching his shows and just being a part of it all, working with a band, because, you know, I love singing. So does Carter. You love it. You love it up here.
I've scraped, I've sanded back, and might I say, I've done some filling. The walls, I did them all. Taubman the hall, and the ceiling. To think, I painted that, and may I say, not in a shy way, although Taubman's helped me, I did it my way. For what is this paint? What has it got? If it's from Taubman's, it's got the lot. And I must say that it was fun. And looking back, now that it's done, the whole house shows, and the good wife knows, I did it my way.
The advertisement for Taubman's paints where hubby paints the house to the tune of My Way. You know that one?
Yes.
It's been a great success, and it had won the award for Best Commercial of the Year. I'd like you to meet the man himself, Carter Edwards.
Welcome, Carter.
Thank you, man.
We have the award over here. What's the story on it? What was the award that the commercial won?
Apparently they run on a similar line as the Logies in Australia. They run it worldwide, and it's a Clio award, and it apparently won the best in the world for 1978.
That's fantastic. Good on you. You're a very enterprising fella, actually. You're from Perth originally.
Yes.
How did you get over here?
I played drums on the back of a truck non-stop from Perth to Sydney. 96 hours it took me to specifically get into the Guinness Book of Records because it was a publicity stunt. When I got over here, I sent all the times and information that I had to the Guinness Book of Records, and they said, hang on, you didn't have a justice of the peace during your Nullarbor trip. It's very hard to get one of those. So they disallowed my attempt. But I did it, and I got here. And when I lobbed, I had every television station, every radio station in Sydney waiting for me. So I arrived with a bang. Bang! Which means if you're game in show business to get out there and do it, you've got to be a prickly cactus rather than a little shrinking violet. You've got to get out there and do it. People notice you. Because the name of the game in Chapin's is, hey, look at me. Look at me. I'm here. That's what it is. That's making a name for yourself.
G'day.
Kia ora. Would you mind opening your bags, please?
Hey?
Your bag, would you mind opening it,
please? Yeah, I got that bit, but what did you say before?
Oh, you mean kia ora?
Yeah, what does that mean?
Oh, well, this is a Māori greeting, you see.
Really? Yeah. When am I going to see one?
One what?
A Māori.
You're looking at one, aren't you?
Oh, you're kidding. You've got clothes on, you speak English. Anyway, your name's,
Yeah, McDonald. How very unusual. Now, your bag, if you don't mind.
Hey, do you know Prince Tui Tekken?
No, I don't.
I didn't think you were a
your
Maori.
Your bag.
All right, all right. You won't find anything in it.
Well, you won't mind if I have a look, then, will you?
Not at all.
What's this?
It's, Eno's. What did you think it was? Drugs or something?
Yes, well, it could have been.
Oh, no way, mate. I'm an Aussie coming to New Zealand, not a Kiwi going to Australia.
Just what is the purpose of your visit here, Mr. Edwards?
I'm here to do a television special.
Well, should I recognise you or something?
Oh, not really. Maybe if I did...
I did it my way.
You're not Frank Sinatra?
No, I'm not Frank Sinatra. My name's...
Edwards. You're not Carter Edwards, are you?
Carter Edwards, yeah.
Would you mind coming with me, please?
What for?
Right this way, thank you.
What have I done?
Just come with me.
What for?
We all know that people are the same wherever you go. There is good and bad in everyone. We learn to live, learn to give each other what we need to survive, together alive.
Because you don't know what a cooler bar tree is or a...
No, I'm willing to learn, eh?
You willing to learn?
Yeah. Give me the drum.
All right. This is the real meaning of waltzing Matilda.
All right.
All right. Once a jolly swagman...
Hold it. What's a swagman?
A swagman's like a bum in America, politician in Australia, or a union organiser here in New Zealand.
Well, you said he was jolly. How come he was jolly?
Same as everybody else gets jolly. Have a few drinks.
Where do you get the booze from?
I don't know, Billy. Will you let me get on with
sorry.
The song? You'll find out later on in the
sorry,
song.
No.
Once a jolly swagman camped by a billabong.
Hang on. What's a billabong?
A billabong. It's kind of like a big puddle, off colour. Kind of
like a pommy's bath.
Like a pommy's bath. I'm not going to rubbish the poms. I'm the last bloke in the world should have a shot of the poms. Because I just recently looked at my own family tree and I found out that my great-great-grandfather was hand-picked by an English judge to go out to Botany Bay in the first place. I'm trying to forget it, right? Once jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree.
Hang on. What's this coolabah tree? What's that?
Coolabah tree. Well, it's kind of like a cowrie tree with a liquor license, all right?
Oh, so that's where we got the booze from then.
Yeah, Billy, that's where we got the booze from.
Okay, I got you. I'm with you.
Andy sang, Andy watched, Andy waited.
So the swagman's name was Andy, right?
What?
His name was Andy.
Where'd you get that from?
Well, you just said Andy sang, Andy watched, Andy waited, you know? Well, obviously the guy's name is Andy.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Tell him, Billy.
All right. We played some tunes, we sang some songs, we shared a laugh or two.
Yeah.
But none of it was meant in disrespect. But when a kiwi meets a kangaroo, said a stay.
Whoa. What else but common laughter could you expect? Just take some time out to be happy. A little relaxation is a cure for all.
You know how to tell when it's summer in Victoria? The rain's warmer.
The truth is hard to come by.
at my heart. Will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this. That one man, scorned and covered with scars, he still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable star.
Two types of people you can learn from in this life. Successful people and unsuccessful people, right? Successful people write books, give motivational talks and sell their tapes and what have you just to try to show you what they've done so you can rote learn their formula. Makes sense, am I right? That's what you should do if you want to be successful. Correct?
I guess.
I guess? There's no I guess about it. If you want to be successful, that's what you should do, yes or no?
Yes.
That wrong. Successful people never share all their secrets because, myself included, we're just too bloody glad to be successful. The less successful people in this world, the better, thank you very much. We don't want to get them too crowded up here. No, here's my advice. You go out and find yourself an unsuccessful person, some complete and utter bloody failure in both their personal and professional life. Sit down with this person, pick his brains, get him to tell you his whole pathetic no hope of life story, write down every word he says, commit it to memory, and then, here's the thing, don't do any of it.
Don't do any of it.
Don't do any of it. Come in. Hello, Lisa.
Hey there.
How are you, Donald? How's that little bloke of yours going?
He's pretty good, thanks, Marty.
Good.
So, did you think you might be able to find a spot for Nikki somewhere?
And what if I don't? Is she going to try and shoot me down like she did those record company people?
How'd you hear about that?
Are you kidding? Listen, there are three things you need to know about that girl. And I'm only telling you this for your own good. Number one, she's crazy. Number two, she can get anybody to do anything at any time without them actually knowing they're doing it. Yeah, except me now, because I'm wise to her. And number three, no offense, but she's got the world's worst taste in men. Now, I don't know where that leaves you, young fella, but good luck to you anyway. Most people learn from their mistakes. I'm doing this workshop so you can learn from everyone else's mistakes as well as mine. So what we hope will happen today is that we might be able to move your career forward, part of that 48 years that I've been in it.
There's no use waiting for top class painting. You can tell it's Tobin's.
I'll paint every room, paint away the gloom. You and the wife can add some light. Offer you the rainbow to make your whole house glow.
Make your house
glow. Don't be confused, just go ahead and choose the name you know,
and let it flow. Paint it big, paint it small. It's just one name that says it all.
It's no use debating or great decorating. You can tell.
I have produced 980 shows in one club alone. I've been there for 18 years. In one club with basically the same audience, I know every entertainer that ever walked on stage. Understand this, put this down. Your audience have seen more shows than you have. They know more about show business than you do.
You know, I've booked anybody in. But you bet your life it's going to be a fun time.
What?
Comes. It's 27 minutes past 11 on 11:43 2HD, coming to you live out of our studios at Newcastle, well, a suburb of Newcastle, Sandgate. Here's a young lady that I'm going to play for you right now. Her name is Melinda Schneider. I had the privilege of working with her for a couple of years down in Sydney at a theatre restaurant called Stepping Out in Penrith, and that was a fun time for me. I learned such a lot from some very talented people, and Melinda Schneider was one of those talented people. She comes from a show business family, having Mary Schneider as a mother and Rita Schneider as her auntie. She couldn't have missed out, could she? She's a great yodeler and a great singer, and she has a marvellous comedic streak in her as well. We did a lot of comedy down there. There was a lot of rehearsed stuff. I had the privilege of writing the show. And the show itself, because of the talent of such people like Melinda and all the other cast, there were 9 people in the cast, we won the best theatre restaurant show in New South Wales for 2 years in a row. And it was just such a privilege to be with this young lady. And she's gone from strength to strength. So she's written this song called The Family Tree. And I'm sure you're going to love it. Right here on Carter Edwards Country, 11:43. Do it, Melinda.
The family tree. He wants at least 2 or 3. He's been waiting impatiently for me to add to the family tree.
See, radio is not difficult. It's a lot of fun. There is a mythical place that everybody strives for. Nobody's ever seen it. Nobody will ever see it. But it's there, and everybody refers to it. The mythical ladder of success. We all want to climb the ladder of success. Doesn't matter what our dream is, and what venture or endeavor that we're trying to achieve. Where is and what is this mythical ladder of success? Nobody knows, but I can guide you to the first rung of that ladder of success, but you have to climb it yourself. I can't do that for you. And let me tell you now, if you have a fear of heights, you'll never make it to the top. In show business, everything is rehearsed, including the formula for success. It's a set down, laid down formula for success.
Time makes you sorry for the things that you've done. Sometimes you walk away.
So I walk out in the rain, 'cause I can't feel anything but you. Tell me, what am I supposed to do?
No rings, no mortgages, and any complications. It's just a happy little bird, and I'm sure I'll be alright.
You've got a great talent. Don't leave it where it is. Take it as far as it'll go. Achieve your maximum potential. Jody, you have such a unique voice. Plus the package that you have, which is yourself, is a great starting point.
All of us have special talents, unique only to you. Some of us are blessed with extra special, finely tuned talents. And Carter is certainly one of those blessed people, even if he doesn't play a mouthful. He is without equal as an upfront compere, comedian, vocalist, psychologist, who has, as his strong bow, a common touch. He makes you feel welcome, relaxed, like an old friend, able to visualise yourself as someone you dream to be. And that's just the effect he has on the blokes. He has successfully written, directed and produced many theatre shows. He's an accomplished corporate motivator and human resource analyst.
We're going to be doing some staff training over a long period of time. Probably once every fortnight, 3 weeks, something like that. And I need to find out what benefit it is to yourselves and the business with going about it this way. I've done it this way in many other places that I've worked with people such as yourself, and it's successful only if you people digest the notes that we give you.
Thank you. Thank you. Morning, folks. Folks, 3 pallets of Fanta here on the floor now in the shop. It's here just for you this morning. 300ml Fanta, normally 99 cents, going out at 59 cents. Or 2 for $1, customers. 2 bottles of Fanta, 3 pallets of it here just for you now. Take it home, put it in the fridge. It's there for the weekend. The kids are going to just absolutely love you for it.
Yes.
Carter Edwards, comedian, entertainer, 2HD radio announcer, happy Toyota owner, and the reason Carter laughs so much, he's just so happy with his new Toyota Land Cruiser Turbo Wagon and the fabulous deal and after-sales service he got from Newcastle Toyota.
Newcastle City Toyota.
It's getting kind of chilly. Summer's had its day. So come on into air.
Very smart, ladies.
The classic way. There's clothes for all the family, and the range is amazing too. We'll dress you right for winter.
Great for winter.
We'll put you in the mood. At Ed's of Lock and Bar. Australians out, we're glad to say. Winter warm for you. At Ed's of Lock and Bar.
G'day folks, Carter Edwards with a reminder that Thunderbolts Retreat have done it again. March the 24th, that's Election Day, a great country music spectacular featuring Macaulay's Raiders, Jack Pledge from Texas, Jan Kelly and Kelly Express, Darcy Lear, Ivy Summerfield and our old mate Wayne Horsburgh will be there, the Gattani Sisters, Anne Kirkpatrick, Eddie Lowe and Lucky Star. So don't miss out. You'll have to book on 665-116 on Election Day. Vote #1 for country music at Thunderbolts Retreat.
G'day, Carroll's Pine's having a special pre-Easter clearance. Bargains like these 2.4-metre pine logs, $6.75 each. That's 40% off. This 90mm kiln dry decking down to $1.49 a metre, plus heaps more. Till Easter Monday at Carroll's Pine Centres.
And now, outside the house.
Taubman's new Extra Tough All-Weather Gloss Acrylic. Extra Tough because it stays hard and glossy for up to 10 years. Extra Tough because it stretches and doesn't crack. And for masonry, Taubman's all-weather cement, brick and fibro acrylic. It's doubly thick so cracks and holes just disappear. Dries to a unique coarse finish that lasts for years, and all-weather cleans up with water.
And I did it my way.
We have from the Mo Awards last night, we have a couple of performers. First of all, this man who I think probably, sadly, is best known for a paint commercial where he sings he did it his way. Yes. Then perhaps he is for television appearances. He's a very good performer in television, and of course in the club he kills them. He won the Most Versatile Entertainer Award. Would you welcome Carter Edwards?
Yeah.
Pardon me, Carter. Next, please. Thank you very much. We've heard all you've got to do. Now, you know what's happened? You know what's happened?
I'll go for it.
Congratulations on the award.
Thank you.
The little bloody microphone has blown up, so we'll throw the one out. Here we have. It's got a nice, reliable cord on it.
Thank you, Uncle Mike.
It should work. This is okay. Thank Carter you. Edwards, ladies and gentlemen. Jeffrey, thank you.
I remember nursery rhymes and good times I had sitting on my daddy's knee. Candy bars and pedal cars and a pup my mum brought home for me. This is Carter Edwards Country coming down the line. If you're a country lover, you're a friend of mine. I got something old, something new for everybody's taste. So grab a beer and get back here, I'll put a smile on your face.
G'day Australia, welcome to Carter Edwards Country. On this show we've got Johnny Chester from Victoria. John Williamson joins us from New South Wales with his monster hit Rip Rip Woodchip. From Queensland, Australia's resident madman, Cole Elliott and Chook of the Roadie. You'll see Frankie Davidson, Reg Lindsay, Wayne Horsburgh and a heap of Aussie talent.
This time goes by so slowly and time can do so much for you, still more I need your love, I need your love, God.
The only people who fail in life are those who give up.